Hello guys, welcome to the 16th episode of the Fake Archetype or Support series. In each episode, I'll show you guys fake archetypes or supports made by me or by someone else. For this episode, the support is for the Rabbit Dragon. The first card here is Rabbit Stone of Legend. It's a light level 1 dragon tuner effect monster with 295 attack, 209 defense. Its effect is you can discard this card to the graveyard to add 1 Rabbit Dragon from your deck to your hand. Once per turn during either player's turn, you can special summon 1 level 1 light dragon type monster from your hand. Once per turn, if this card is in your graveyard, you can shuffle 1 card you control into the deck, add this card back to your hand. You can only activate each effect of the Rabbit Stone of Legend once per turn and only once that turn only. As you can see, this card is pretty much the White Stone of Legend, the Black Stone of Legend, the White Stone of Ancients for Rabbit Dragon. As you can see, this the effects of Rabbit Stone of Legend has pretty much all 3 effects. It has the search effect from the White Stone of Legend, the Special Summon effect from the Ancient White Stones, and it has the shuffled back to your added back to your hand effect from the Black Stone of Legend. So it has pretty much has one of the each of their effects. The next card is Rabbit Stone Tablet. It's a light level 1 dragon tuner effect monster with 295 attack, 209 defense. The effect is if this card is summoned, you can add 1 rabbit card from your deck to your hand. You could tribute this card to special summon 1 Rabbit Dragon from your hand, deck, or graveyard. During the end phase, if this card is in your graveyard, you can banish this card from your graveyard, special summon 1 Rabbit Dragon from your hand, deck, or graveyard. Really overpowered. You can only use such effect of Rabbit Stone Tablet once per turn and only once turn down only to balance it out. So you can see this is pretty much the Ancient White Stone with an additional effect where you summon, you can add a Rabbit card because this support archetype is going to have some spell and trap cards. The next card is Rabbitus Rabbit Dragon. It's a light level 10 dragon fusion effect monster with 44 25 attack, 43 50 defense. It requires 1 Rabbit Dragon plus 2 non-pendulum normal and an or dragon type monsters. Must be fusion summoned with the above fusion materials. This card's name becomes Rabbit Dragon while it's on the field or in the graveyard, unaffected by your opponent's card effects. This card gains the following effects depending on the other 2 fusion materials used to fusion summon this card. 1 dragon type and 1 non-pendulum normal monster. If this face-up card attacks the defense position monster your opponent controls, inflict double piercing damage. 2 dragon type monsters. Once per turn, during either player's battle phase, if this card destroys an opponent monster by battle and sent to the graveyard, you can banish 1 non-pendulum normal monster from your hand, field, or graveyard, inflict damage to your opponent equal to that destroyed monster's attack, and if you do, this card can make a second attack. 2 non-pendulum normal monsters. Once per turn, during either player's turn, you can banish 1 non-pendulum normal monster from your hand, field, or graveyard, banish 1 card in your opponent's hand, field, or graveyard face down. If this card is tributed or leaves the field by a card, either by battle or by card effect, you can special summon as many banished non-pendulum normal monsters to your side of the field. This effect's activation cannot be negated. If you have a dragon type and it's a non-pendulum normal monster, you get all of these effects, like literally all 3 of these effects. So pretty much this card is really gonna be overpowered. And if you tribute this card, kaiju this card, destroy by battle, and if managedly you destroyed it by card effect, it gains the return from the different dimension effect, only for non-pendulum normal monsters. This is an old one because this is back when before Link was introduced. So the next card is Rabbit Ambush. It's a continuous spell card that reads, once per turn, if you control normal monsters, you can special summon 1 non-pendulum normal monster from your hand. If a non-pendulum normal monster will be destroyed by battle or by card effect, you can banish this face-up card from your field or graveyard instead. So this card is pretty much a support for all non-pendulum monsters, especially for Rabbit Dragon, which is a normal monster that's not pendulum. The next card is Rabbit Wave. It's a continuous spell card that reads, once per turn, if your opponent controls more monsters than you do, you can special summon 1 non-pendulum normal monster from your graveyard. If a non-pendulum normal monster will be destroyed by battle by card effect, you can banish this face-up card instead from your field or graveyard. So, from the previous one, you can see they all revolve around the hand, field, or graveyard. But this one revolves around graveyard. And as long as your opponent has more monsters than you do, and you have multiple copies of this, you can special summon up to 3 monsters. As long as your opponent has more monsters than you do. And if you have any extra dead monsters that were summoned properly from the graveyard, then yeah. The next card is Rabbit Path. It's a continuous spell card that reads, once per turn, you can add 1 Rabbit Dragon or 1 non-pendulum normal monster from your deck to your graveyard to your hand. All face-up Rabbit Dragon and non-pendulum normal monsters are affected by your opponent's card effects that does not target. If a non-printed normal monster will be destroyed by battle by card effect, you can banish this face-up card from your field or graveyard instead. So as the previous two cards, they have the same last effect. Non-printed normal monster will be destroyed by battle by card effect, you can banish this face-up card, yada yada. And this one is really good because it searches and it could be abused a lot because it's not even a once per turn only. So you can have multiple copies of this and search three cards in one turn, which is really overpowered. That's why I said non-pendulum normal monsters, because you could either search for blue eyes, red eyes, or any other normal monsters that's not pendulum. The next card is Rabid Mountains. It's a continuous spell card that reads, once per turn, you can shuffle up to 3 banished Rabid cards into the deck, then draw 1 card. All face-up Rabid Dragon and non-pendulum normal monsters cannot be targeted by your opponent's card effects. If a non-pendulum normal monster will be destroyed by battle by a card effect, you can banish this face-up card from your field or graveyard instead. So this card is pretty much the Digusto Emerald or the Pot of Creed that targets 3 banished monsters and shuffle back. To draw 1 card. So yeah, that's pretty much this card, but it's a continuous spell card and you can have multiple copies of this. It's not once per turn, once per turn only. The last card here is Rabid Domain. It's a field spell card that reads, once per turn, you can discard 1 non-pendulum normal monster from your hand. Draw 2 cards. You can only use this effect of Rabid Domain once per turn and only once that turn. All face-up non-pendulum normal monsters you control gain 300 attack and defense. Neither player can banish non-pendulum normal monsters on the field or in the graveyard. If this face-up card will be destroyed by battle, by card effect, you can send 1 non-pendulum normal monster from your hand, deck, or field to the graveyard instead. So this card is pretty much the strong suit. It pretty much has the discard 1 card, draw 2 cards, but it's a field spell, so it's gonna be there forever. And to make sure it's balanced out, you can only use this once per turn, so you cannot just slap in another copy of this and draw 2 whole more cards. And also, all your non-pendulum normal monsters gain 300 attack and defense. So, Rabid Dragon would be 3250. Yeah, 3250 attack. And it has the Imperial Iron Roll effect where neither players cannot banish non-pendulum normal monsters from the field or the graveyard. So, yeah, that's really good. So, that way they can banish your Rabid Dragon, your Blue Watch White Dragon, your Black Eyes, Black Dragon. And if this card will be destroyed, like by card effect, you just send 1 non-pendulum monster from your hand, deck, and field. Like, simple as that, to make protection. And that's it for the fake support for Rabid Dragon. Thanks for watching, and let's see what happens next. Thank you.